Hello, friends, and welcome to day 15 of our Advent adventure, our daily mini art journal practice. Today is all about the Christmas bow. Bows, they are everywhere at Christmas time. We wrap bows around our Christmas gifts, we decorate our homes with them, and we decorate our trees, and you might even see a bow tie to the front of a car. Bows are often a finishing touch placed on the center of a gift, making whatever they're on look beautiful and complete. Jesus has the same effect on our lives. He is the finishing touch. When placed in the center of everything we do, he unites us with one another and empowers us to share his love. Ephesians 4:3 says, "Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace." When we make Jesus the center of our lives, he promises us his peace and wants us to share it with the world. Our takeaway today: how can you share Jesus with your friends and family when you give them a gift? So I am going to start today by sketching in a bow. In the past, I have had a few students express their fear of drawing a bow, and the bows are actually quite simple. My biggest challenge is finding a pencil. Hold on. There we go. So, let's see here. So I'm going to put a bow right in the center. So, you can sketch yourself a couple lines here. Okay, and find your center point. I will trace this over darker for you. Maybe I should use red. Go up. Okay, so I drew the two lines, made kind of an ovally rectangle shape in the middle, and then just simply, you can start by doing just a rounded one piece like this, and then give it a crease in that center, and then from here, we'll draw a couple lines down and make this the tie. Not that difficult. Now, what we want to do is give it some folds. So, I can split this so that there's four hoops. So if I just see that, what I did there? Like a sideways teardrop. And this one can come from here. Now, this one I might just flatten out a little. And those are never like exactly the same looking, like each section aren't always the same. So I'm going to make this side a little different. I'll put the hoop on the bottom. Okay, and put a little hoop here. And that's it. Okay, so you're going to do the, draw yourself two lines in the center, with this kind of rectangle shape and round your edges. One big hoop, and then from that hoop you can pinch it in the center. And then make yourself a teardrop in one. And then another kind of part teardrop in the other. So you can play around with it and make it like that. Now, what we want to do is paint this in. So I'm going to use red, so it kind of go with this page, and I'm going to use a warm red. This is a warmer red, and this is a cooler red. So I'll use a cooler red for in the shadowed areas, and a warm red for the outsides, and we'll do some shadowing as well. Okay. I'm also going to, with my palette knife, take a little bit of my cool red and add just a tinge. And when I say tinge, I mean tinge, so just a tiny little bit. See that on the edge of my, just on the point of black? Because you can add a little bit at a time. I just want to darken this a little bit. So this is the same paint that I had squirted out from, I'm not sure which day, 3 or 4 days ago. It's starting to get a little bit thick, so I'm going to give it a little mist. But this is what that Stay Wet palette can do. So there, are you seeing now the difference in the colors? This is a warm red. This is cooler. And I've mixed a little bit of black with this to make it a little bit darker, so it'll give a shadow effect. Okay. Just going to mist my paints with and I have a flat nylon brush, just flat nylon. Paint in these. Now, if your paper is thinner, you might want to have gessoed this first. I'm just going to grab a smaller nylon to fit in those little areas there. So you're going to see as I paint in the areas that would go down, it would be creating a bit of a shadow and cooler. So you may see me grabbing some of the cooler red, and the parts that would be closer to you are warmer. So I will be using the warmer red. So just maybe kind of pay attention to how I start to give this form by which one of the reds that I grab there. And it's going to be a little streaky, so I'm going to use a little gesso as I paint as well. That will give me a little more slide and glide. If you only have one kind of red, you can add a little bit of blue to it to cool it down. So that will make it a little bit purpley, and that will give you that cooler red color. You can also use black to do that, but purple will, blue will do kind of the same trick. Thank you. And there you have it, a Christmas bow painted in acrylics. I'll probably give that background another coat. But my hope for you is that you wrap yourself in Jesus' love this Christmas. Please like, subscribe, and share. And we'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for joining me.